Yep, and it felt like we needed to talk about this a little bit more, so we kind of shuffled the deck a little bit, and we're going to talk. We were supposed to talk with our current guest about something else, but we're going to talk about this because of who he is and his appearance on the show. Let's bring in Adam Thompson now to talk about the situation in New York. Adam, are you there?
I'm here.
All right, Adam, thanks for being with us. And, you know, we wanted to get your reaction first when you heard about the execution, also what you heard with the gunman posting stuff online, telling folks that they should watch what he's going to do. Talk to us about this. What was your reaction?
I mean, it's just unbelievable. I mean, we're reaching a real low point in this country that, you know, like Martin Luther King said decades ago, violence begets violence. And I don't know how it's entered into the minds of some people, because I've read some posts online on Twitter or Facebook, and there's actually people out there that are happy or applauding what happened. And anyone that thinks that this is a good thing or revenge or payback because there were some questionable police encounters with civilians and people died, that this is the proper response or answer, boy, do they have it wrong, and boy, are they confused. We need to really get leadership from every possible angle, from the mayor's office, the police commissioner's office, every minority leader group out there. And this shouldn't be a black or white issue. We should be hearing from the president. Congress should issue a statement. I think this has to be so wide sweeping at this point, because we now have a situation where cops are being executed and there's a section of the public that thinks it's okay. That's got to end immediately. That's completely wrong. It's disgusting, and something has to be done about it.
Adam, you were talking about leadership. People have been very critical to Blasio in regards to his remarks that he made earlier prior to the shooting. Do you think that's fair? Do you think Blasio is in part to blame? Some people say he is.
Well, I think he was just trying to, you know, trigger his base and show that he hears their concerns and was speaking in the moment. In retrospect, I think if he went back in time, he might have changed what he said, actually. I don't blame anyone for an execution-style murder perpetrated by, you know, the person that ended up killing himself. I mean, that's just such an aberration of conduct and any kind of ethics or morals. So, but still, people respond to what they hear leadership saying. And if people in leadership positions, and this starts from the president down, local level, someone like de Blasio, and even community leaders, you have your Al Sharptons and all those, they need to send strong messages out that as a community, we all need to work together, get past any kind of problems we have through conversation and dialogue, not through violence. And when we see protest march turn into violence and we hear chants of it's okay to kill the police, right, things like right. that, it has to make you think something's wrong.
So Adam, with that being said, can anyone be held legally accountable for this?
Well, other than the person that committed the actual crime itself, I don't think so. I don't think there's any words that inspired or triggered an incite to riot or something along those lines, that those words led to these actions. So I don't believe that. What is interesting is they are looking into the background of the suspect who killed himself to see exactly what ties he has to other groups. And I remember weeks back, there was some information about whether he was part, you know, there was a group called the Black Guerrilla Family. That's a big notorious gang that they had put out some execution hits on police officers, and now they're thinking there may be ties between this suspect and that group. So it'll be very interesting to see how that develops.
Adam, real quickly, we only got a couple of seconds left, but I wanted to ask you, we reported on some other copycat threats. Should those folks face criminal prosecution?
Well, you know, if they're making real serious threats online, you have to take all kinds of threats at this point seriously, because look, this suspect posted online what he was going to do. So it has to be that point where words can lead to actions, and you got to take them seriously at this point.
All right, Adam Thompson, thanks so much for being with us, criminal defense attorney. We're coming right back.